Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. Now, in this particular video today, I'm going to show you how to bring back focus into an out of focus image. Before we dive into this video, please take a minute to subscribe to this channel, give this video a thumbs up, and of course, leave comments below of what exactly has resonated with you. And if you're a beginner photographer or even an advanced photographer and you want to take your retouching to the next level and you want to master retouching, create those high-end fashion magazine quality images, click the first link in the description below and join the Retouching Secrets Masterclass today. Let's get into the tutorial already. Yes, I'm going to show you how to smartly sharpen an image without going through without using either the sharpening tool that gives you weird results and also using the sharpening presets that are usually here into the filters. Here we are going to use a technique called frequency separation to basically bring back focus into an image. It is going to go through two phases. One, we are going to do sharpening of the contours, and then we are going to do sharpening of the actual skin, that tactile skin. When I say contours, I mean the edges, the lines, the shadows. And when I say the particular textures, bringing back these textures here, that is now the second phase of a sharpening we are going to do. Now, let us dive into this already. Now, what are we going to do? We are going to come here and let's duplicate this layer twice, just like that. And then we are going to rename this upper. This is now going to be our sharpen. And now this is going to be this is what we're going to blur out. Yeah, it sounds weird right now, but I'm going to show you how we're going to do it. So now we are going to come, we unsee this, you say filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Now, when you're doing, first of all, since you're going to do fast sharpening of the contours, we're just going to come and blur out until we see that the lines in the shadows are blurred out. You see these shadows, these hard shadows, until we see that they are blurred out. Alternatively, you can just look at the edges. You know, if you see the edges blurred out, you just know you're on course. Yeah, just like that. So we shall come here and say okay. Then we shall come here into the upper layer that had the sharpened layer. Here we shall come here and say image. You say apply image. And then you come here and you choose the blur layer, just like that. Keep the blending mode at subtract here, the scale at 2 and the offset at 128 and also this at 100. So you come here and say, okay. So the next thing you're going to do, you're just going to come here and put this into linear light. After putting it into linear light, you realize that nothing has really happened, right? So what you're going to do, we're just going to come and just remove the opacity in the blur layer. Okay, you see how it's what has happened. If we reduce the opacity in the blur layer, look at that. That's the before and that's the after. Before and after, before and after. Now we're going to get onto the second phase. Now we've brought back detail into the contouring here, into these edges and all that. So now I want to get details back into the parts of the skin, this that you see the skin here, so that we get a little bit of like pores. Basically what we are doing is just creating a bit of grain to imitate skin. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm just going to create a stamp on top of this layer. How do I do that? I press Ctrl Alt Shift and E, or Command Option Shift and E if you're using a Mac, right there. And then what we are going to do now, we are going to call this details. So we're going to duplicate the details twice again. And then again, we're going to come here. We're going to call this again, details blur. That's what I'm going to name it, just for, so that we remember. And we're going to name this sharpen, yeah, skin. Okay. So we come, make sure this one is not seen. So you come and select the details blur layer. So you come here again to filter again, and then you say blur, Gaussian blur. And then since we are targeting skin, we are going to make sure that the only thing that we blur out in this particular piece is just going to be these pixels that you see here. So we are just going to take it we're going to take it at very, the blur is going to be very slight since we want it to affect only and only the upper part of the skin, just right there. Because here we want now sharpness in the details, yeah? So I think a 1 out of 1 is okay. So we're going to come and select this, the upper layer. We say image, apply. Again, since we had already used the frequency separation technique, we are just now going to come and select the detail blur from here. See here, details, blur, just right there. Keep the blending at subtract, then scale at 2, then at 128. Of course, you just come and select subtract here. Eh? So you come and say, okay. The other thing, you come here and then you say linear light. So what are we going to do now? You guessed it. We're now going to come and just reduce the opacity in the detail blur, just like that. Now, see how we've brought back details into the picture? Now, there is one challenge. Yes, the details have come back, but we have actually a lot of noise, that RGB noise. We don't want to have this noise. So how do we get rid of it? I'm just going to come and create a stamp. Press Ctrl Alt Shift E. And then I take it into the camera raw filter. Filter, you say, camera raw filter. Now here, I'm just going to zoom it in and get into the sharpening panel. This one that has detail. So you come where you see color, just here. And then you just punch down. You just bring down, you just actually kill that RGB effect. You see how it's working here? Removing all that color knob only. So don't take it overboard because it may make the image look a bit pale. So as soon as I have it removed, I'll say, okay. Now, let me just put this in a group. We'll look at the before and after. Look at this. Now, that was the before. That is the after. Before and after. Now, isn't that so amazing that you can bring back sharpness into an image? Even this one now, even if you print it in any other in an album or you give it out for social media, this is a very, very technically competent image, a decent image that can really be used. It is now more usable than it was. That's that for today. If you've not yet subscribed to this channel, come on, subscribe to this channel right now. And of course, turn on notifications so that you don't miss my next amazing tutorial. I'll see you in the next one. And adios. If you're a photographer who wants to level up the quality and outlook of your final images, no matter the camera, the one thing you should be focusing on learning and mastering right now is high-end retouching. In the past 10 years, I've helped thousands of photographers like you kickstart their businesses, and I can tell you, high-end retouching is by far the most important skill any new photographer can learn. It adds 10 times more value to an average image. And it is for this reason I've put together a masterclass called Retouching Secrets, where I teach you everything I've learned from retouching thousands of images for my portrait and commercial clients. Inside, you're going to discover the basics of high-end retouching, the tools you need. I will reveal to you the image assessment secrets to help you retouch any kind of photo, no matter the lighting. You'll also get an overview of the color theory, an introduction to professional retouching techniques. Then after, I will show you over a dozen real-world examples where you will watch over my shoulder as I work on real client photos, and you will learn how to retouch the most common scenarios you are likely to come across. With these tools, techniques, and secrets in your hands, you will be able to create amazing high-end glamour images for your clients, no matter the camera you are currently using. So if you are ready to take your photography to the next granular level, click the link down here and get started right now.